the gold medal today. NBC Sports presents the 2016 Secret U.S. Classic. Oftentimes the home for the sport of gymnastics, this is the XL Center. And a big crowd is here to cheer on their favorites as the road to Rio continues to be paved. Hi, everybody. I'm Al Trawig, along with my favorite two Olympic gold medalists, Nastia Lukin and Tim Daggett. Andrea Joyce will be along a little bit later. So there used to be room for a Magnificent Seven. Now it's down to five gymnasts per team. Who is allowed right now to think they can represent the United States in Brazil?
Well, in my opinion, the most dominant athlete in the world today, male or female, is Simone Biles, three-time world champion. She just doesn't ever lose. Because of that, she's going to go to Rio.
To put it in perspective, she hasn't lost an all-around competition in almost 3 years. That's how good she is.
Who's next?
Well, Gabby Douglas, I mean, when you're the reigning Olympic all-around champion, that gives you some props. But I gotta tell you, I don't think that anybody besides Simone is an absolute lock. She's just gotta do what she's capable of doing, and she'll get that ticket as well.
Yeah, you know, she hasn't exactly been the Gabby Douglas we saw in 2012, but she has some time, and she's on her way to getting there.
How about the captain?
Allie Raceman, and she was one of the reasons that really the gel of that team in 2012, so competitive and just never missed at all. If she is Allie Raceman as she's always been, no problem, she's going to Rio as well.
Which brings us to tonight. Why, Tim, are Gabby Douglas and Simone Biles only doing half of the four rotations?
Well, you know, Al, I just spoke with Marta Corley about 10 minutes ago, and she said that she encouraged the established athletes to not be at 100% here and didn't want them to do the all-around. They're already secure in their spot. It's time for the other ones to get their jump.
Okay, so the Secret Classic is not an Olympic Trials. It's not a Nationals. They're coming up in the weeks ahead on NBC Sports. But you're going to see some young faces tonight who are feeling the pressure of what the Trials and what the Nationals are going to be like. There are performances tonight that are going to matter.
Absolutely. And for them, this is where the Olympic Games starts. You know, they have to do well at this competition. For Simone Biles, if she has a mistake or falls, it doesn't matter. She's still a lock. But for some of these athletes, it matters tonight.
So we've got Simone Biles, the greatest gymnast in the world right now, and a couple of hopeful American gymnasts who want to go to Rio and have their second Olympic chance. It all starts next, and it will be filled with all sorts of gymnastics emotion. The Secret U.S. Classic is brought to you by Pampers, wishing you love, sleep, and play. And so we begin here tonight in the center of Connecticut, in New England. Simone Biles sitting out this rotation. We will see her, but only half a dose of Simone Biles here tonight. We begin with Ashton Locklear on the uneven bars. So where does she fit into this Olympic puzzle?
Well, as Nastia said, for some athletes, there are key routines, and it all starts right here in Hartford. This on uneven bars is so critical for Ashton. The U.S., historically not the strongest event is the uneven bars. She's been to a Worlds. She's been in the individual Worlds Finals. I think she was fourth on the uneven bars.
But this is exactly where she can earn her Olympic ticket, on this event right here.
And we look at Marta Corley, longtime national team coordinator. Ashton has beautiful long lines, and she does a lot of skills in between the bars. Look how her feet go in between her hands. She'll do it again right there. Those are big bonus points. Perfect form, just completely locked knees, toes, good handstand positions. Big release right here. Oh. If there's a place she struggles, it's on her dismount.
Not that time, right?
Oh, absolutely. Pretty darn good.
You know the most impressive thing? Marta kind of likes it. But the most impressive thing about that bar team, not only is her difficulty high, but Tim, as you said, the execution. Her toes are glued. Her knees are straight. She just about stuck that landing.
You hear that Nastia is fighting through it a little bit, and that's sometimes what you have to do in gymnastics.
Absolutely. But see how she does this skill. She'll put her feet right in between her hands. It's called an inside skill, and it raises the difficulty.
And this release move that Ashton does is called a Jaeger. Look at those toes pointed, and she sees the bar.
And when she grabs, they stay pointed. A lot of athletes, when they grab the bar,
and this is where Tim said she struggles sometimes. She does a full twisting double back as her dismount. You want to see her knees and toes together again? A little bit cross, but almost a stick.
Yeah, very, very, very close.
We will get her score in a moment. When the sport of gymnastics went away from the perfect 10 scoring system, it became very difficult to figure out what a good score was because the high-level scores are different on the floor apparatus. So we decided to talk about the deductions. And if you can keep your deductions to a minimum, you really help yourself. So when you keep your deductions to a minimum, it's green, you're good to go. When you go higher than that, it's cautious, be careful, and then two or more is bad.
Look out.
Bring everything to a halt. Since Marta Caroli took over the women's sport of gymnastics, she has created an absolute dynasty.
Well, it's a machine, really. And, you know, I talked with her about it recently, and she said that, you know, we're the only country in the world that does it the way we do it now. It's a semi-centralized system. And one of the things that she says is so key is kids like Ashton or Madison or Simone Biles, they were already training with the top seniors when they were just little kids.
Ashton Locklear, she's good to go with a 15.85.
Wow, that is absolutely gigantic. Only 5.5 tenths of a point in execution. Wow. Marta looks a little befuddled.
There's a lot going on in there, Tim.
Yeah.
All right, here's Alyssa Bauman. She trains in Plano, Texas, which should sound familiar.
Absolutely. Alyssa has been at WOGA since she was just about 3 years old. Got to watch her grow up and train from a little mommy and me class to now a world champion.
Oh, boy, and that. She went over the wrong way. Had a form deduction. She will really incur a lot of heavy deductions. Marta Caroli, right before the meet, told me she's really happy with the way that she looks. But she said to me, can she handle the mental aspect of it? That's what we're always looking for. Unfortunately, oh, geez, nowhere near on that dismount.
So Nastia, was the first mistake a nervous one to you, and did the first mistake help create the second mistake?
Yes, the first mistake absolutely created the second mistake because she was just a little bit out of gas at the end. She didn't have as much strength because she had to add a few more skills, a few more moves because of that first mistake.
So for this young lady right here, remember, for an outsider like her or like Locklear, this is the start of her Olympic trials, and that's a very bad, very, very bad start.
And here's where it went wrong. She did a toe on, and she went to a 360, and you see she's already a little bit in front of the bar. It looks like she just didn't quite circle over enough. But as you said, it's all about fighting, and, you know, she tried her absolute best. She didn't quite come off. But it's going to be a huge deduction.
Nastia, you haven't made many, but when you did have a major mistake, did your father ever say anything to you that actually made you feel better?
Not really.
Okay.
You know, there's not really much of, nobody can really say anything to kind of erase that mistake.
We'll take a break here on the Secret U.S. Classic. We'll stay on the uneven bars. Allie Raisman coming up, and so is hopeful Madison Koshman. First confidence hit of the night, and it's a big one, and it'll have to be absorbed by Alyssa Bauman if she can save her night. A 13.150. Does it affect you when the gymnast before you goes and has an experience like this?
Well, it would affect lots of people, but not Allie Raisman. Absolutely not. And you know, this is where Allie, she struggles. This is by far her weakest event.
Not only does she struggle, but she's always said she's always most nervous on this.
And that is shocking. That is absolutely shocking.
And that is why you said before, is it not? Nothing is guaranteed.
Nothing is guaranteed. And see, what they're talking about right here is she, that is an element that she needs in her routine. And so she was wondering if she needs to repeat it. And yes, she does. So here we go. Same move. Another release right here. And this is okay, but it is just, she's running a little scared. Small form breaks. You see her legs, they kind of come apart just a little bit. Now her dismount.
But there's a little crack in the door, perhaps, for someone to climb into their situation here tonight.
Yeah, that doesn't help at all. And you know, at the World Championship, she was put in for the qualification round, first event up, and she fell on the uneven bars. She said she couldn't believe she was on her hands and knees looking at the mat, and that really, if you know this young lady and you know her strengths, that is shocking.
And here's that fall. You see, she does. She gets her toes on the bar, and when she lets go, she just didn't quite get enough rotation. She wasn't even close to grabbing the bar. And we watched her do it in training all week and didn't miss a single one.
The element right before that, she got a little wiggy on and had, you know, she typically has a form break, but had a very big form break on it. And I think she just lost focus.
Yeah, you look at that face and tell me if she thinks it's just the secret class.
No.
And to focus on the next event.
Right.
Exactly what
the one thing that she does have going for her is Team USA, even in the qualifying rounds, doesn't want to use Allie Raceman on the uneven bars. She is a huge asset to the team on floor exercise. She's the reigning Olympic champion there. So let's watch right here. This is the first element. She's a little shy on the handstand, and then she gets a little wiggy. Watch how her legs come apart, and she doesn't think she's gonna get over at first, I think. And because of that, she's a little rushed. Not enough height, not enough rotation towards the bar, and 1 point off.
She's even a little bit worse than Bauman was. Roga sends us another one. How long have you known?
Just the Koshin. Same. Just the same. She came in at 3 years old.
Doesn't that blow your mind a little bit?
I try not to let it, but it really does. But this event for her, that connection right there was very crucial. She missed it at the World Championships. And another one.
Oh. And this is one of those absolute key routines. Remember, her biggest competitor for that team is probably Ashton Locklear, who just knocked it out of the park. But she's pretty darn good too. Reigning world champion along with three other gymnasts, but
that's exactly the performance Madison Koshin needed tonight.
Not much of a reaction there from Marta Crowley. Perhaps she just expected to see that.
You know, I think the bigger test and challenge for Madison and both Ashton as well will come on the next event on the balance beam. Because Marta knows that both Madison and Ashton can hit a great bar routine, but can they hit a beam routine under pressure?
She's just so elegant on unevens and just beautiful lines. She does exactly what the essence of gymnastics is. Do the most difficult skills, this is one of them right here, and in combination, make it look absolutely effortless. That's the move, very similar to what we just saw Allie Raceman fall on.
And here's the dismount. She does the same exact dismount as Ashton. She connects it with the Stalder 360, lands straight in a handstand. Gonna watch her toes a little bit.
And just like, almost exactly like Ashton, just, she didn't
little
really.
Feet shuffling.
Yeah, shuffling, right.
No steps.
Meanwhile, Nastia, how deep is this Team USA going to be, no matter who gets it?
Well, this team, you know, we've always said that Team USA could really send two full teams to the Olympic Games and go 1-2, if not both win the gold medal, if that was possible.
Regan Smith, and your eyes are not deceiving you. She can actually walk under the front bar.
I asked her, I said, so if you put your hair up in a really big bun, do you hit it then? And she said, no, sadly, I don't.
Huge score by Madison, 15.70. So we've had two major messes and two great scores.
About a tenth and a half, though, less than what we saw Ashton get. This young lady is coached by one of the all-time greats, Kim Zemeskal, world champion in the all-around. And she is a little daredevil. So much power, so quick. She's actually improved quite a bit on the uneven bars, but where she will be most valuable is on her next event, balance beam, where she's shockingly good. Very clean exercise, though.
Here's Kim. Kim's actually not that much taller than Reagan.
I know.
Our first floor exercise performance coming up, and it's from New Jersey's Christina Desiderio.
She is from the longtime gymnastics club of Parkettes, Bill and Donna Strauss. Powerful athlete.
Olympic year. You feel a little pressure, but she definitely didn't show that.
Reagan Smith gets a very solid 14.9. And that's going to end the first rotation here in Hartford, Connecticut at the Secret Classic, where some little flaws become not so secret. Back after this. In the middle of that crowd is someone who stands out. Wearing red, that is American Simone Biles. Unprecedented is a word that comes to mind. Winning more medals than anyone ever has. And she only needs one more thing, and it's so close, to make it the most complete resume in history. Three straight world titles. Al Trawick, Tim Daggett, Nastia Lukin. Is she better than you?
Gosh, by far.
Okay, no. Just asking.
No, she's different.
Yes, no, she's definitely way better. I don't even know what it feels like to be that dominant, to go into any competition and know that you are going to win.
Yeah, Tim, to me, as someone who doesn't know nearly as much, her amplitude is manlike.
Oh, it is, and we've actually seen her frame by frame compared to other men, and sometimes she's even more powerful, and we're not talking about just normal guys. We're talking about the best in the world, like Kohei Uchimura. But this young lady right here, Simone Biles, she could go to Rio and come back home with 5 of the 6 Olympic gold medals, and that would not be shocking to me at all.
Okay, she had to take the longest road, feeling as good as she possibly could be. She's now 62 days away. Is she nervous? I know she said on her Twitter account, I just looked at the calendar and it said 2016. Whoa.
You know, when we talked to her this week, she really didn't seem nervous. She said, I don't even think about it. But when you guys asked me about it, of course, she forced me to think about it.
So Simone Biles getting set to go on her first of 2 performances that we'll see tonight in Connecticut at the 2016 Secret Classic. This June and July, the stars of Team USA compete to punch their ticket to the 2016 Rio Olympic Games. U.S. Olympic Trials this June and July on NBC and NBCSN, a journey that'll take us through St. Louis, Missouri, and San Jose, California. Simone Biles, the most important name in the gymnastics conversation right now. There's another name that was for a while, but right now is not. For more on that and the story of Maggie Nichols, we go to Andrea Joyce.
Well, Al, Maggie Nichols is not here. She is back home in Minnesota working her way through a knee injury. This is an athlete who had an amazing breakout 2015. She was 2nd at U.S. Nationals. She was a member of the gold medal world championship team and was 2nd to Gabby Douglas at American Cup. And then the untimely bump in the road in April during vault training, Maggie tore her meniscus, had to have surgery. Her coach, Sarah Jancy, told us that her recovery and her rehab is right on schedule. They fully expect her to be at Nationals competing in a couple of weeks. Remember, the last time Maggie Nichols was injured, she came back stronger physically and mentally. She was a completely different athlete. We don't know what's going to happen, but Al, they don't call her Swaggy Maggie for nothing.
I like it. Another reason to watch the Nationals. We'll see Simone Biles as she warms up on the uneven bars. But right now, we take you to the floor for a second time and our first look at another New Jersey gymnast, Jasmine Foberg.
Yep, she won the Junior National Championships 2 years ago, then placed 2nd last year to her teammate, Lori Hernandez, who we'll also see later.
Unfortunately, she had a rough start on her first event. I believe she fell off the balance beam. Marta Caroli, right before the meet, told me she was very impressed with this young girl. She's battling an injury, has come back very strong. But I think we've seen, you know, quite a bit of nerves from some of the athletes that are, you know, on that bubble. The ones that are first trying to qualify into St. Louis, the Nationals, and then the Olympic Trials. Step out and 3/10 for that step. Mistake of the routine, that's a full point off. shame because she's very capable, does extremely difficult tumbling. She just unfortunately wasn't able to handle all the passes.
So that's Jasmine Foberg. In his book, The Winner Within, legendary basketball coach Pat Riley talks about the Thunderbolt and how you have to prepare your players to deal with it. It's a sudden, unexpected turn of bad luck. And we're going to see, because Marta Crowley wants to see it, how does Ms. Bauman handle her recent Thunderbolt?
Yeah, and this is where Alyssa really is very good. You know, she performs every move, every step, every skill with such precision and confidence.
Now on balance beam for Hoka, Alyssa Bauman.
Really all about the mental game for a lot of these athletes because they're capable physically. She's got a big test coming up right off the top, right here. Excellent.
But that is one of my favorite series, seeing three skills in a row take up the entire balance beam.
Nice leap right there, very difficult. Tips her head back on it.
Now on uneven bars for Twin City Twisters, Patty Paulson.
Right from the start, a completely different look to Alyssa. This has been confident, and she has delivered. Just put this to her feet. Really good.
That was great.
Really good.
Talk about a comeback.
Jasmine Foberg, a 12.8.
This is called an Arabian. It's a blind landing, jumps up, does a half turn, and then front flip somehow finds that 4-inch piece of balance beam.
And here's that series. You see a back handspring, back layout, just a tiny bobble there, but.
Yeah, maybe a tenth.
Not a big deal.
Mm-hmm. She did a really nice job on this. Sometimes the power, not exceptional, lands a little bit with her chest down to her legs, and that can be maybe a 3/10 deduction for that, but overall, very strong routine.
So a nice little comeback for her. We are going to take you over to Vault and Michaela Skinner. And whoever coined the phrase on the bubble, I think, really nailed it. Because if you think about it, if you're on the bubble, when the bubble pops, you're like Don Draper at the beginning of Mad Men, emotionally in free fall. So where does Michaela fit in?
This is one of the most critical routines of the entire competition with that Olympic formula. Who's going to get there? And that is a big exclamation mark for Michaela Skinner.
Even with the landing?
No, absolutely. You know, in 2012, the U.S. team at the Olympics was so dominant, and it was because of vaulting. And right now, they've lost some of the gymnasts that are capable of doing this vault. It's called an Aminar. Same one we'll see from Simone Biles. Big block and just spins like crazy. Good form. 2.5 twists around. One step forward, but pretty darn good.
Alyssa Bauman, nice bounce back, 15.35.
And you see that max score, 16.6, that's a big number. Lots of difficulty in there.
All right, let's see how Allie Raceman responds from her misadventure on the uneven bars.
Right off the bat.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, this has been tremendous thus far. It's just she is at home on this piece of equipment on the uneven bars where we saw her struggle. It's not natural to her. This is, you know, all the hard work certainly happens, but she just has a natural aptitude for balance beam.
Dismount left, and this is a very difficult dismount called the Patterson. Line landing.
That was fantastic.
That's the Allie Raisman we are used to seeing.
And I just saw something that I think I only saw at the Olympics after they won the team gold medal. Mihai Breschin, that guy right there, he actually applauded. And, you know, he recognizes when things are really good, but usually he is as stoic as they come. But that was fabulous.
We see the good score from Michaela Skinner, 15.4. And now the time has come. The world's most dominant gymnast. She can even, as you've told me, she could go to Rio, fall a couple of times and still win gold.
Yes, she could.
That's unbelievable.
But what you just said, fall a couple of times, she doesn't fall. That's what's unbelievable. Do this in combination to a release skill. Very nice. And now a release skill to a transition to low. Beautiful. Seen her do this basic routine many, many times, and it frequently looks exactly like this. No visible errors.
Just putting another check by it.
So completely confident. That's Coach Amy Borman, her longtime coach, basically from the beginning. But watch this right here. She'll do what's called a reverse heck or a Tkachev. Nice height. And the tricky thing is she's got to transition right from that to the low bar. Look at that position. Gorgeous in the air. That's called a pack salto.
And here's the dismount. We've seen a few other gymnasts do it, but I don't think anybody gets quite as high as Simone Biles does. A full twisting double back. You see her knees glued together. She spots the landing.
Wow.
I'd call that basically a stick.
Yeah.
Another Simone Biles pre-Olympic statement here tonight in Hartford, Connecticut. Nice turnaround by Allie Raisman as two. 15.0, that's green and good to go for her. More of the secret U.S. Classic after this. Simone Biles getting a few well-deserved high tens. She gets a 15.1 here tonight. Now, she hasn't lost an event she's entered in about 3 years, but she's not going to win here tonight. She's not doing the whole deal. She's only doing two events. Now we're going to stay with the balance beam with Madison Koshin.
This is a very big routine as well. You know, we've been talking about this, you know, the formula of the team, and Ashton Locklear, Madison Koshin, they're stars on bars, but also right here, big one. She crashed on that just the other day in training.
Nancy, I think that's one of the most impressive things in sports, that flip where your head is next to the beams. How do you do that the first time?
I could never do that, so I'm not sure.
Beautiful series right here. Remember Madison or Ashton could make the team purely because of uneven bars, but Marta Caroli likes gymnasts that can be counted on in other places, and balance beam is that other aspect of the selection.
Purely nerves.
Boy.
One of the easiest skills in her entire routine.
Boy. Doesn't matter how pretty it was, you come off the beam. Pretty much stuck landing, but a full point off and... Yeah. She's disgusted with that. And you know, in a lot of ways, I think that if Marta believes that it was nerves, it's even worse. Because you can fall on things, and everybody does fall, except for Simone. But if Marta believes that that was because of nerves, that's even worse for her.
Yeah, because Brazil is going to be this times 10.
Absolutely. So just yesterday in training, I saw her do this and completely miss both feet on the beam, which is easy to do because it's so narrow and it's blind. Half turn, then a front flip. That one a little bit low on the landing.
Look at this. You can really see how narrow the beam is, but completely blind landing, as Tim just said. Really no room for error. And here's where she had the mistake, just a regular back tuck. Again, one of the easiest skills in her entire beam routine. And to me, that was just a fluke. There was nothing really technically wrong. Maybe her chest was a little too low, but I can't tell you how many times she's done that skill perfectly.
So a little bit of a confused mind right there.
Well, it just shows how much is on the line.
Yeah.
Madison knows that.
I said a moment ago, in terms of pressure, Brazil's going to be this times 10. I decided it's going to be this times a million.
Yeah, pretty much.
Reagan Smith won the balance beam earlier this year at the Pacific Rim competition, beating out Allie Raisman.
And you know, one person's disappointment can be another's opportunity. And I said this when Reagan was on bars, if she has a routine that's critical, it's balance beam, where she can really set herself apart. She already did a great job on bars, so Marta, at least at this point, knows she can count on her.
And Nastia, you were on the tall side. We've told you how she is on the short side. Does it help her out to be short on an apparatus like this?
You know, I think on the balance beam, I don't think it matters too much. I think the uneven bars, some of those transitions are a little bit more difficult when you're on the shorter side. But it's also more difficult when you're tall because you could hit the bar easily.
It's very difficult. These are called wolf turns. Her coach, Kim Zemeskal, said to me as they were checking in, you know, there's a lot of different gymnasts, and some of them are seniors, some of them are juniors, and she went up and the lady said, "Junior?" And she went, "Nope, I'm big time this year." And this is big time. Very, very difficult right here. Back somersault, full twist, perfect. Plan. Oh, Arabian double. Wow. Arabian double front, the same thing we saw Allie do.
Her knee looked a little close to touching the ground. We'll have to watch a replay.
Good job.
Couldn't quite tell from this angle.
I don't think they take the, you know, the full, if her knees go down, it's a full point off. And I don't think so. Sometimes the things that don't look so hard are really hard. Very tricky. It's called a wolf turn. Need a tremendous amount of leg strength, obviously, and balance comes in handy there.
Look at that stretched body position. That is very difficult to do. A lot of people try, but they aren't able to do it the way that she just did.
And right here, back full, just rock solid, perfect.
And here's that dismount. What makes it even harder than Allie's is she does two back handsprings immediately into the double Arabian, blind landing, and didn't quite touch.
Yeah, I didn't think so. So, you know, but it doesn't matter what we see. It matters what the judges
exactly
think. And that was close. And sometimes it can go your way, and sometimes it doesn't.
Did you go in there with no floor team too, and it was quiet?
Nobody's going there.
She really looks very unaffected.
I like to go in bars whenever nobody's watching.
Me
too. So, as we said, very difficult, and as Nastia pointed out, even more so when done in combination like this. Little bit sloppy in the air, but this is new for her. And somehow, look at those knees. They do not touch the ground. Very close, but.
No concern there. Now, Koshy's score was a 13.65. Reagan Smith gets one of those yellow scores in terms of the overall standings. Be careful. Now our first look at North Carolina's Emily Shield.
Teammate of Ashton Locklear's. Very nice.
So far doesn't seem too affected. Any kind of pressure of an Olympic year.
Ooh, a little bit under-rotated. So she wasn't vertical when she hit the beam and able to hold on. So a lot of the gymnasts gain points by what's called connection, doing one thing into another. Some of her connection bonus points have been a little bit questionable. Here's the dismount though.
Chest down a little bit on that landing, but overall a great routine.
Now I'm sure that this is a tremendous experience for her being here. I don't think she feels that she's, you know, definitely part of the conversation for going all the way to Rio, but she's a young, tremendous kid that's got a great future.
We've talked an awful lot about Rio and what this event plays in it. And of course, everybody wants to do that, but there are some gymnasts who think winning the Secret Classic would be awesome, right?
Oh, well, without a doubt. And there was that front flip near the top of the routine, doesn't have quite enough rotation.
And here's that dismount again. You see two back handsprings into an immediate double pike dismount, which makes it harder when you connect a few more skills in front of it. Look at where her chest is.
Right.
Really low, actually,
yeah.
When we watch it in replay, in the slow motion.
Yeah, but you know, it's brutal. I think they should get rid of that deduction. I really do, because you stick a landing in gymnastics and that deserves props. And, you know, they take it, though, believe me. That one right there, if they do it right, that was a full half point off for a stuck landing. That's not right.
Exactly.
Kelly Shield, 13.85.
Now, Ashton
Locklear, who got off to such a good start in her first performance.
She absolutely did, but this routine is what really matters, just like Madison Koshin. So we're going to have to see if she can live up to the pressure. Great first element.
Solid so far. Ooh, good fight on that. Was a little bit off. That element near the end, the same one we saw Madison come off the beam on. So, this is a big routine for her. She had the highest score on the uneven bars, and it looks like clean exercise. Wow, mission accomplished, Ashton Locklear.
Absolutely, that is what she came here to do. Hit two of, for two events.
And that brings us to the end of rotation two. When we come back, the second and final performance of Simone Biles on the night. It will come on the uneven bars. We're at halftime at the 2016 Secret U.S. Classic. Why not be all smiles when you've had the career so far of Simone Biles? In a moment, she'll do her second and final event here. She's part of a system that wins and has a gold standard. Since 2011, the United States had the world's gold, Olympics gold, then the world's, and this is Simone Biles' time, gold, and then in 2015, gold in Glasgow. Al Troutwick, Tim Daggett, and Nastia Lukin. Nastia, you are a direct part of the success of this system. I know things like this are often hard to put into words, but if you had to try, what would you say?
A dynasty, exactly how you open.
But how do they do it?
Well, I think the system that Marta Garoli has really established, I think the girls training together, them getting to know each other, both inside and outside the gym, and it's just the young talent as well. You know, it's the young talent is pushing these girls to be better and to be stronger year after year.
You know, when Carly Patterson won, it felt like, okay, that's one to cherish for a while. Mm-hmm. And then this one came along, and we thought that's one to cherish for a while. Yeah. And here we are watching it again.
No, absolutely. You can't forget Gabby. She won the last one, and Simone, I don't know what kind of catastrophe would have to happen, but it would have to be this. But speaking about how dominant Team USA is, we've talked about how great Simone is, not just great, phenomenal. USA is so good, they could go to Rio without her, and I believe they'd still win a gold medal. That's how good they are. Take their very best person and leave them behind, they're still going to win.
Now, see, if you had to pick a team right now of the gymnasts that you have seen, how hard would that be for you?
I think today it's made it a little bit easier. Of course, we've seen a lot of uncharacteristic mistakes, but I think, you know, those few that we already know that we kind of called at the top of the show, and then those two extra girls that were trying to fill those spots, I think today definitely helped us out.
In the weeks ahead, the Nationals and the Olympic Trials, and we're excited that during our coverage of those events, the Olympic teams will be announced before we go off the air. When we come back, the U.S. Classic, presented by Secret, continues here in Hartford, Connecticut. This August, the world will come together in Rio de Janeiro as the athletes from across the globe compete for country and Olympic gold. It's the Southern Hemisphere's first Olympics since the 2016 Olympic Games, coming August 5th through the networks of NBC Universal. We've said over the years that there are certain coaches who just have that knack, and Liang Chao is one of those guys. We also talked about there being different levels of anticipation for this event tonight, and Rachel Gowie is a perfect example of that. She is coached by that man, Liang Xiao, and right now, here at the halfway point, she is the leader.
And of course, Chow was, you know, coached the great Shawn Johnson onto Olympic gold, as well as Gabby Douglas onto the Olympic all-around gold medal at the 2012 Olympic Games.
And I'll tell you, when I first saw Rachel, I thought he might have another one, but then she had a very serious ankle injury. She broke the bone in 2004 at the national championships. Well, a nice fall, good power. A couple of big steps on the landing. Those are 0.3 each. And you know, really, ever since she did that to her ankles, I mean, you see them there, so heavily taped. And you know, landing backwards like she's going to do right here, it's so hard. And believe it or not, even when she does it well, this hurts a lot. Okay, the force that you're coming into the floor on. She's never quite been able to get back to the form she had before that injury. She was doing that same vault that we talk about over and over again, the Aminar. She's the reigning Olympic champion. She says, my routine is way harder now than it was then, and I still can't even come close to hanging with Simone Biles. That was fantastic, but Mihai shaking his head. The corner judge raised the yellow flag. They're going to call it both feet in or both feet out or 1 foot.
Beautiful. Watch this third pass. She does a double layout, but watch how high she gets.
One of her tumbling paths, I feel like I'm a little kid watching the Batman series. It's like Karpow! Unbelievable. Such huge, huge energy. Great height. Somebody just said they're a little bit crooked. So if you are crooked on the diagonal, it is much easier to go too long. The diagonal is the longest. And that left foot, that was out. But it could have been both feet out.
So he's shaking his head because she took the wrong route.
No, he's thinking that it was incorrect. And you see, if any part of the body, and you can kind of see the rug where it's indented right on the white. And I would say that was the correct call, a harsh one, but correct. But only 1/10 of a point.
The uneven bars, world champion team member with the United States medal in 2014.
She said this year, she said, I'm way more prepared than I was for this experience than I was 4 years ago.
Oh boy, and that is another huge error. We saw this from Allie, and Michaela is not known for bars. See the leg splits. The error at the top, though, she fell the wrong way. Was supposed to go over the bar in the handstand. Release. She was planning to do very difficult dismount. Two flips with two twists, Don't know if she's going to do that. Yes, she does. Oh, wow. Wow, really, really hard. But see, that's a demonstration of risk and reward. She gets an extra 10 between two for doing the harder dismount. But the landing deduction with her legs apart, that was a little bit of a hot mess, unfortunately.
Drives me crazy when you say that was a major mistake and I don't see any of it.
Yeah, well, what's supposed to happen here is she's supposed to go over the bar. So she's going to cast up to a handstand. And right here, she's supposed to continue past the handstand here. Doesn't have enough to get over. Hops her hands. Has to do a cover up right there. Everybody knows it's a mistake. But then what that did is it rattled her. And you see the feet right there.
But here's that dismount that she did, a double twisting, double back. Much harder than we've seen from everybody else, including Simone Biles. But watch her form, especially on that last, very end, really. From that angle, it doesn't look too bad, but her chest was really low, her legs were apart on the landing, but very difficult dismount.
Well, Raceman gets a 15.5.
And that is really hard to do. You see that 1 point? In execution deductions on floor exercise, that is no small task.
So she was sixth after the second rotation. She was probably gonna gain some serious ground here because Gowie, who was the leader, gets a 14.7. And now, Gabrielle Douglas. She was second here last year to Simone Biles.
You know, she really shocked the world last year. She really did. You know, she says, you know, there were a lot of doubters, a lot of haters out there. And she went to the World Championships, you know, and it was her first major meet back besides the trials process. And she was a rock. She was second to Simone Biles, which is, it's just unheard of.
She told us that I'm my biggest critic and she was focusing on myself and what she needed to do in gymnastics because it's already a tough sport. So she's not listening to any of those critics. The crowd been excited.
And she has had a tremendous year so far. She won the American Cup and then, oh boy.
Taylor Skinner.
The U.S. team always travels to Italy, to Jessalo, and she won that all around as well. So here is the most intricate part, and she struggled a little bit on this in workout right there. Very difficult. And very well done.
She's ready to go.
Pretty darn good. Oh, boy. Wow.
Nasi, is this harder than what she did in London?
Yeah, she's definitely added some major difficulty to this bar team, but I think even more than physically, I think mentally, it's a lot harder than when she was competing at the 2012 Nationals, the trials. She wasn't expected to win the all-around gold medal. Here, not a single person doesn't know who she is.
I tell you, that was really good, and this is very difficult. She's going to turn her back to the bar here. This is called an inverted giant. Go right into this straddle swing to a handstand. I've never seen anybody in the world do that type of combination on the low bar. And then a huge release back up to the high bar.
And here's the dismount. She does a double layout. So what you want to look for is that her hips are straight and opened all the way to the end. A little bit of a pike down, but I think they'll give it to her.
And a perfect landing. That's a stick.
We'll get Gabby Douglas to score, although it doesn't matter because she's not going to be in the standings. And now our second and final look at the three-time world champion.
Now she'll spin an extra full turn more. Oh, actually, I don't think she did on that one. This is very difficult. Front flip, half turn.
Ooh. A little off, but great save.
I love that move.
Another series. Beautifully done. And that was one of those connections that she was hoping to get, and that will be too much of a pause in between them. She'll lose a tenth of a point. Just gotta focus on her feet a little bit. You know, these athletes are so developed, they almost become like hands. Those toes wrap around the sides of the beam. This is a big time dismount. Full twisting double, does it well. Oh! Oh. You know, Al, I mean, there have been lots of tremendous athletes and many amazing gymnasts, but nobody doesn't fall ever on balance beam. They just don't do that. But so watch right here. She goes around, I believe, another half turn more than we've seen so far. So that increases the difficulty.
And here was that first skill, a front flip with a half turn, and you see her eyes are glued to the beam, and her foot was just almost, you see her right heel come off the beam. Yeah. But had a great save.
And many people would have been right off the beam on this, but she's patient, she doesn't panic. And that's what you try to teach people, but for her, it's a little bit innate.
And here's the dismount that we love. Two back handsprings into a full twisting double back, but look at the height. Just incredible. Nobody does it that well. Almost had the stick.
Yeah.
We have to measure how high she does get. Oh. It's got to be 10 or 11 feet.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Well, Gabby Douglas got a huge 15.65 on her performance. Now here's Alyssa Bowman. She was in second place after the second rotation, after the weight thing started. If she could sort of make a step here, that would be very exciting for her.
Very solid. She had a great comeback after struggling on her first event. Bars was great on beam, and this was really good for her as well.
Nice symmetrical way for two of the stars of the sport to put up scores of identical nature. 15.65 for Gabby Douglas, which is followed up by a Simone Biles score of 15.65 on the balance beam. On we go, and we could have a surprise champion here tonight in Hartford, Connecticut. Nice job by Alyssa Bauman. Slow start, maybe a big finish, 14.55 on the floor. We go to Brenna Dowell on the beam. She's been part of that American Access we were talking a few minutes ago.
Competed at the University of Oklahoma for a year and then decided, you know, I want to give it another shot and try to make this Olympic team. So put that on hold.
Pacific Rim Championships this year. Ended up in fourth place in the all-around, had the fourth highest score, but the two per country rule only put her out of contention with that. But really for her, a dream came true in 2015 when she was selected as a member of the world team. She competed in the qualifying round, struggled, but she is a world champion nonetheless, and deservedly so. Big dismount, double pike.
Just pretty low on that landing, as we've seen in some of the other gymnasts, but a good routine.
She checks in with longtime coach Al Fong. Simone Biles has made her statement here in Hartford, Connecticut. She looks like she is good to go. We'll take a break. This is the secret U.S. Classic. Back at the XL Center in Hartford, Connecticut. Gymnasts getting ready for the fourth and final rotation. Meanwhile, Andrea Joyce has a very special guest.
Hey, Al, look who I found. The one person in the arena who knows exactly what Gabby and Allie are going through. Olympic champion, world champion, Svetlana Boganskaya. Not two straight Olympics, three consecutive Olympics, 88, 92, and 96. What do you remember as the special challenge of being able to come back again and again to an Olympics?
Well, when you take a small break after the first Olympics, then it's so much harder to get back because juniors stepping on your toes, literally. So now I see Gabby and Allie, they are great. So when you come to the podium, each competition counts. You have to be on top of your games because those juniors are just really, really good.
Now, I'm going to gush a little bit. You were such a beautiful gymnast. I mean, people called you the goddess of gymnastics. Yes. But you were also the fiercest competitor on the planet. I mean, you were just rock solid out there, fierce. All the changes in gymnastics, do you think that hasn't changed? Do they still need that kind of mindset? How important is it?
Yes, absolutely. I think gymnastics is 90% mental. Physically, you know how to do all your skills. All you have to do is just focus. Set your mind on yourself. That's it. Ignore everybody else.
Right, sounds like a good coach, right? Back to you, Al. Thanks so much.
And that's exactly what she is now, the queen of gymnastics. Yes. Gabby Douglas has one more routine to come tonight, and that will happen in just a few minutes. Meanwhile, a shakeup in the third rotation. In spite of a miss, Allie Raisman grabs the lead, if only by a tenth, over Rachel Gowie, who had the lead at the halfway point. And we go to the uneven bars for Lori Hernandez, who told the New York Times, because of a patella tendon injury, that she has the ligament of a dead guy in my body. It's one of the great quotes.
She's awesome. Great personality. She was the junior national champion last year. Has been coming on strong. Had a little bit of a re-injury to that knee. Marta told me, you know, They never really knew exactly what happened with it, but she's doing very well. She trained all the events here, but only is doing bars, and it's an upgraded routine.
Great combination. So far, so good.
Marta really likes her, says she has a definite shot. She is in contention and did absolutely no harm right there.
Even not doing me all around, she definitely helped herself tonight.
Michaela Skinner about to mount the beam. Stock up or stock down for Michaela tonight?
Well, you know, where she really matters on vaulting, stock definitely up. Marta told me before the meet began that, you know, this young lady, because of that vault alone, she is in the conversation. Marta doesn't like to see people fall, though. That's for sure. And this is one of the most challenging beam routines you're gonna see. She also does that backflip with a full twist. Done in combination really well. And she has an upgraded dismount plan, the same one we saw from Simone Biles, the full twisting double somersault.
Connect those three skills, but not sure she's gonna get the connection bonus for that.
This is new for her. Marta was very keen on seeing how this would turn out. Full twisting double out of a round off. Nicely done. She certainly brings to the table plenty of difficulty. Where she falls short is some of the artistic components. Sometimes the legs aren't as split as they need to be, 180 degrees. It's a little bit choppy here and there.
Lori Hernandez, a very solid 15.4. We go over to the vault, and if I could have whispered at the uneven bars in Alyssa Bauma's ear right after she had her two mistakes, hey, relax, you're going to be on the podium at the end of the night. I'm not sure she would have believed it, but that could happen.
Yeah, it can.
Now,
floor
exercise for Metroplex.
Great ball, a little bit the legs crossed in the air, a big hop on the landing, but you know what, that's a good ball for Alyssa. You know, she doesn't do as big of a vault as, you know, say Simone Biles or Ali Raisman, but a double twisting Yurchenko.
Yeah, very nicely done. A little bit squashed on the table. You see a little bit of bent arms, and when you do that, you lose some of the bounce, but look at the legs a little bit apart. Actually has a great body position when she lands, which is critical, so she only gets the deduction for the hop back. Really, she just needs to clean it up a little bit, you know, get those legs pasted together, those knees locked, but plenty of power on that.
Pretty quick tally for her, 14.75.
I got tired because I did the pirouette.
Right in front of us is Ali Raisman. Michaela Skinner got a 14.5.
Good score, strong score.
Good for being classic, right?
So we're at that point. Ali Raisman needs to beat a 14.35 to hold first place.
Puts it to her feet, no problem at all. And she wins it. Not the way she wanted to. But without question, Allie Raisman is the secret classic champion for 2016. The first step in the official qualifying procedure for Rio.
So quite a bumpy ride today for Allie Raisman, but it looks like she's going to wind up on top. We'll be back and see Gabby Douglas. Very many deductions at all on that vault by Allie Raisman, who puts her in the lead and then keeps it there with a 15.7. At the end, a job well done for her. And now Gabby Douglas, she had such a confident body language when she did her first performance here tonight.
She definitely wants to hit this beam routine. You know, again, she's not doing the all-around competition, not worrying about her placements, but two strong, hit, clean routines will definitely help her out, especially confidence-wise.
Pretty funny. She was asked if she was worried about traveling to Rio and the Zika virus, and she said, "I ain't afraid of no bugs." Basically, paraphrasing there a little bit, but I think she said stupid bugs,
yeah,
right?
I was going to say, she added this.
She gets the green flag, and here we go.
Foot completely slides off the balance beam. That'll raise your heart rate. Big skill right here. Back with a full. Rock solid. Dismount here done out of two back handsprings makes it more difficult. The double pike. Little bit of a scare right off the top of the routine, but really strong, almost an instant comeback.
And here that was, that first skill. Look at her foot when she lands on the beam. You see that left foot completely off the beam, basically standing on one leg.
That's amazing.
Here's another look from this angle.
Once again.
Totally off.
And not just that foot, but much of the right leg wasn't on the beam as well. Wow.
Most people would have just fallen off.
Backflip with a full twist. Really difficult. We've seen a bunch of them. That one is about as good as it can get.
And the dismount, as we said, she did it with two back handsprings, which again makes it that much harder because of the connecting skills into the double pike. And let's watch for her chest on the landing. A little low, but she picks it up pretty quickly.
So summarize her night, Tim.
Well, you know, I think if I were Marta Caroli, her bars were great, and you know, as expected. And Beam was very good. But what I like the most is she was handed a struggle, a challenge, and she didn't falter. You know, she was so far off on that beam, and somehow the great ones figure out a way to stay on. And she, in a lot of ways, that maybe looks better than a perfect routine for Gabby Douglas.
That was first look tonight at Lexi Rambler from Minnesota.
Very nice routine. She's staying home. She has committed to the Golden Gophers at the University of Minnesota.
Gabby Douglas is not going to be in the standings. Tim is so proud of the way he pronounced that. Gabby Douglas on the balance being 14.55. So, her night is done. We have one more gymnast to go, and she had the lead in this competition halfway through. And then Allie Raisman had a nice comeback. So where do you think about where Gabby Douglas is right now with Rio in mind?
Well, I think she had a great night tonight. You know, she did exactly what she wanted to do. Come out here, do two clean routines. Yes, she had that slight bobble on beam. And as Tim said, she proved that she was a fighter, and that's exactly what Marta is looking for. So on to the next one in 2 weeks.
Yeah, that was a little rougher on score-wise, you know, 14-5-5. You know, there was definitely an error there, but I didn't really think there were a lot of deductions associated with it. And, you know, for Allie Raisman, you know, when you come right down to it, Marta Corley knows that she doesn't want to use Allie Raisman, even in the qualifying, on the uneven bars. So, yes, she's going to be disappointed, but Allie Raisman on the next three events was a rock star, like she typically is. And so stock for that young lady, way up.
And stock up for Ashton Locklear as well. You know, we know she can do a great bar routine. Not great, but an amazing bar routine. But what she proved today, it was on the balance beam. She went under pressure, and she performed a great routine. Yes, it's not the highest difficulty. It's not as great as Simone Biles, but she did what she needed to do, which was to stay on the balance beam.
But I think she had the highest score of the entire competition with a 15.85 on the uneven bars. That is Olympic medal worthy.
If you were 100% here, then you would have no shot.
Simone Biles, her star can't get any bigger. Lori Hernandez, she only did one event tonight. She's coming back a little bit from a dinged up knee, but she did a fabulous jar routine on the uneven bars. A much improved event, higher difficulty now, and her stock only went up as well. Marta Caroli told me before the competition began that absolutely she is part of the conversation and a very big contender for Rio.
Now Rachel Gowie, one-time leader Now he needs 14.45 to move into second place, and that would be a significant achievement for her. Second place to an Olympic gold medalist.
And she was supposed to connect those two skills. She'll lose a little bit of difficulty. She's a very nice bar worker. Good transition from high to low there. A good routine. She was the Pan Am champion on the uneven bars in 2015. There's her coach once again, Yang Chao.
We'll take a break one last time. When we come back, the breaks with Gowie. Get to second place behind Ali Raisman. And we've got some interviews with Andrea Joyce. That's it. The Secret U.S. Classic is in the books with the Nationals and Trials coming up. The Secret U.S. Classic has been brought to you by Tide. Find the Tide that's right for you at Tide.com. If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide. Rachel Gowie needed a 14.45. Guess what? She got a 14.65 to finish second to an Olympic gold medalist. That's a career highlight for her. Alyssa Bauman with a tremendous turnaround to take third. Let's talk to Ali Raisman via Andrea Joyce.
Al, never a dull moment. Ali, after that first rotation, how were you able to rebound and come back and win the competition? What was the key?
It's always really crazy. Like, you're trying to think positive, and then 1 second you feel good, then the next you're off the bar. So I tried to just think, if I make the Olympic team, it's not for bars, so I have to come back strong on the other three.
You have talked openly about nerves and about butterflies and about how nerve-wracking this is. With all of your experience, are you surprised that it's not easier this second time around?
I don't know. I mean, I guess, you know, people would think, but it's still just so stressful. Like, every single night before I go to sleep, I have butterflies in my stomach. It's like, I can't turn it off. I think all the girls were trying to stick together, but we all are kind of freaking out.
You won this competition in 2012, went on to become a successful Olympian. Do you believe in omens?
Yes, I do. So hopefully I'll be able to be back on that team and representing USA.
All right, congratulations. Al?
Well, that got us a laugh. We're all kind of just freaking out. Well, from the beginning of this night in Hartford, Connecticut, Ashton Locklear didn't look like it. She had a tremendous look of confidence, and she is with Andrea Joyce.
Ashton, congratulations. What are you hoping Marta saw out there today?
I'm hoping that she saw that my beam was better and I was able to stay solid, you know, but my bars, I kind of missed a connection, so that's kind of frustrating because I don't remember the last time I did that, and I don't know. I hope she knows that it was just kind of like a fluke thing, but I think I did pretty good.
But after competing the way that you did tonight, do you have a sense that you put yourself in a great position to make the Olympic team? What do you bring to that team?
I don't know. I mean, we still have a lot of time left. I think I did pretty good, and I hope that she saw that I did good, and I don't know. I hope, yeah.
Do you sense the intensity building? I mean, for some of the athletes, Simone knows she's a lock, but for you, what's it like out there?
It's definitely intense. I mean, the past couple, like, weeks have been, like, hard training, you know, trying to build up for competitions and stuff, but it is intense, yeah.
Congratulations on a nice night.
Thanks.
Al?
Okay, so we saw a lot of facial expressions tonight from Marta. You know them well, Nastia. Did they tell you anything?
Well, yeah, there was definitely a few disappointments and a few disappointing looks from Marta. You know, of course, uncharacteristic falls and mistakes, but there were, of course, a few happy faces. And so I think, you know, everybody did well in general. There's time, a few weeks until the national championships, a few weeks until the final Olympic trials.
It's going to be interesting to see the relationship between Gabby Douglas and Simone Biles if this Olympics thing happens.
Well, without a doubt, you got the reigning Olympic champion. You got maybe the best ever. It's going to be quite an unbelievable, exciting time, that's for sure.
So we've got the Nationals and the trials to come, and as I mentioned earlier, we're very excited that in our coverage of the trials, we will know the Olympic teams before we go off the air. We got to get out of here because Nastia needs a hot toddy stat. Join us June 23rd through the 26th for the U.S. Men's Olympic Trials, as well as the Women's P&G Championships from St. Louis, Missouri. Then on July 8th and 10th, it's the U.S. Women's Olympic Trials in San Jose. Coming up next on NBCSN, it's stage one of the Criterium du Dauphiné. So for Tim Daggett, Nastia Lukin, and Andrea Joyce, I'm Al Trowick saying goodnight from Hartford, Connecticut. But we can't wait to see you again from St. Louis and San Jose. Allie Raisman wins it.